Hi everybody. Recently I've had a lot of customers asking me how much contract manufacturing is going to cost in their situations. So today I'm going to give you the same primer I give to potential customers who are looking for pricing but not exactly sure how contract manufacturers generate their pricing structure. This is simply a primer, and many CMs use different methods based on their business model, vertical integration, accounting structure, and other factors. The first thing I do when determining an estimate of cost for a piece of machinery or equipment is to look at the bill of materials. Typically in a machine, there are a few categories of goods, these being custom fabricated parts like brackets, frames, or plates, commercial off-the-shelf items, maybe hardware, motors, or sensors, customized, modified, or specialty goods like lasers or heaters, and packaging materials, skids, or foam in place. By taking the value of these items, we can apply a factor to get the necessary costs. The factor depends on a few things. First, whether an item will be supplier managed and purchased. In this method, the contract manufacturer will purchase, manage, and inventory the items. The factor here can range from 15 to 30%. This depends on factors like company business models or project complexion. The other method of markup is customer managed or consignment. Consignment rates are lower than vendor management markups, ranging around 6 to 10%, with the customer taking ownership of supply chain management, quality, and delivery of the parts to the contract manufacturer. Some companies like PEKO can be flexible and provide creative approaches in how parts are managed. Labor hours are the next factor. In the USA, you're going to see rates from $65 to $150 per hour, depending on the project. Labor hours are typically generated from assembly, testing, and packing labor. Sometimes the assembly time is known for a machine, other times it must be estimated. Either way, we apply a simple rate times time calculation to get a broad picture of the assembly costs. Testing and packaging follow the same protocol with some nuances in rate and time. It's wise to ask the CM which of these activities is covered in overhead versus labor. For instance, some companies may not charge for packaging or material handling, as those personnel may be part of the overhead. Understanding what the rates cover and what they don't cover will be an important part of your analysis. When discussing costs for building machines, there will be some engineering involvement beyond what the assembly technicians are providing. The important part here in engineering calculations will be to understand whether engineering will be adding labor on each build, like special testing, or as a non-recurring charge with design assistance or test development. Again, here we apply a rate times labor and add that to the calculations. Non-recurring engineering charges are most likely to occur in the early life cycle stage of equipment or during onboarding. Some other factors to consider when developing costs for contract manufacturing machinery are life cycle stage, annual quantities, physical dimensions, special requirements, certifications, and risk. I hope that answers some of the questions about how pricing is generated by a contract manufacturer. With this video and a calculator, you might even be able to generate your own estimates. Contact PEKO today if you want an accurate price on your next machinery project.